Hello and welcome to another tutorial of LTSpice. In my previous two tutorials, you have seen that I have demonstrated a very basic features of the LTSpice. Those were the transient response, frequency domain response, DC transfer analysis, DC operating point analysis, and noise analysis. In addition to them, I also have discussed how you can incorporate a third-party device into your LTSpice module so that you can use those devices also which are not been included within the default device list of the LTSpice. However, in this lecture or in this tutorial, I'll show you how can we use the LTSpice to design a very basic analog circuit such as the Weinrich oscillator, the phase shift oscillator, how can we use 2L5 timer to design astable and monostable multivibrator. Although, in particular, this tutorial will focus on the design of Weinrich oscillator. In my next tutorials, I will discuss one after another. So these devices, as I told, the phase shift oscillator and the usage of 2L5 timers. So for today, let's start the design of Weinrich oscillator. So this one is the first interface of the LTSpice. And as we know that we cannot draw any circuit or we cannot simulate this one because this interface is empty and we need to create the new schematic file. Now we can draw or we can put our own devices. So first I should go to over there and I need to put an op amp and OP07. This operational amplifier is a generic one. You can use this one also, but I'm interested to put a simple one, so AD8033. So this is an operational amplifier having 85 MHz of bandwidth and it's a FET input amplifier. You can use any other one also. So I'm not giving any specifications regarding the bandwidth because the 85 MHz bandwidth is sufficient for our work. Because in this tutorial, I'm going to design an oscillator which will produce a signal that will oscillate any frequency starting from 1 kHz to 10 kHz. So although although the device will generate the signal, that will oscillate a particular frequency. So for our demonstration, I may choose there 1 kHz or 5 kHz. 5 kHz can be chosen. So for that, 85 MHz is good enough. So therefore, I am choosing this one. This is the positive supply. This one is the negative supply. So I have to give its supply first. So going for battery over here and here. Connecting to ground and tagging as plus VCC for the positive supply and minus VEE for the negative supply. That should be VEE. And I can copy this one for the negative supply. I should place these two battery a bit away from the main region of the circuit design, but I will design the circuit. So now two resistor I'm placing. This one is R1 and this one R2. And these two resistor will make a negative feedback network, and that will be connected with the negative inverting terminal of the operational amplifier. Well, as we know, in case of Weinrich oscillators or any kind of oscillator, when we are going to design, so we need to satisfy two criteria. One is the condition of oscillation, another is the frequency of oscillation. So condition of oscillation and the frequency of oscillation, both conditions are achieved using the Barkhausen criteria. So if you are interested to the detailed theory of Weinrich oscillator and phase shift oscillator, so you can go to my my lectures on analog electronics. So the links are given in given below in the description box. Here the condition of oscillation is maintained through the ratio of this R2 and R1. So in general, for a Wien bridge oscillator, the condition of oscillation is R2 will be 2 times of R1. That is the minimum requirement. Whereas the frequency of oscillation is achieved through the feedback which contains the reactive elements, which means the resistor and capacitor. So therefore, the reactive elements is connected to this non-inverting terminal for the Wien bridge oscillator. So therefore, I am first considering this resistor R and another, next the capacitor and another. So I am connecting this resistor and capacitor. These two resistor and capacitor will be in parallel configuration and they will be connected, and it will be connected with the non-inverting terminal of the operational amplifier, and finally this capacitor will go to the output. And here I can tag this output as V naught, and I can make it as output. Well, oh, I need to put a ground. Either you can put a ground directly over here, or you can connect both of these, this terminal with here, and that will connect the ground automatically. Anyway, in order to achieve the frequency of oscillations, we know for Wien bridge oscillator, this resistor R3 and R4 should be equal to each other, and these capacitors C1 and C2 should also be equal to each other. Well, now I'm going to calculate the frequency of oscillation, what will be the frequency of oscillation, and based on which I am going to decide what should be the value of R1 and R2, value of R4 and R3 and C1 and C2, although R3 and R4 will be equal. Now, according to the theory of the Wien bridge oscillator, the frequency of oscillation, angular frequency of oscillation omega, is equals to 1 over R times C, and that R, either this R times this C or this R times this C, because this resistor and this resistor are equal, and this capacitor and this capacitor are equal. Well, now if this is the theory and I am considering that my operation or my device will produce a oscillation of 5 kilohertz, so therefore omega is equals to 1 over RC, and omega is equals to 2 pi times f, the frequency. So frequency is, right now I am considering it is 5 kilohertz, so 5k. So 2 pi times 5k is equals to 1 over RC. Now here either you can choose R and you can calculate C, or you can choose C to and you can calculate the R. So I am going to calculate right now the what will be the capacitor value or the resistor value. So here I will use the maxima to calculate all of these things, although the purpose of the maxima is not so simple. So the maxima can calculate a very complex equation. Later on, when I will discuss many circuits, I will also demonstrate you very basic features of the maxima, so that you will be interested to use this maxima instead of the commercial softwares like Maple and any other one. Well, so I need to calculate the suppose capacitor C is equals to 1 over 2 times pi. I will write directly as 22 divided by 7 times R. I am considering it is 5k, so 5e3. So it is the value of the resistor I'm choosing, and that will give us I missed the frequency. 2 pi f. F is 5 kilohertz. So this is 2 pi and f. And thereafter, I need to multiply the resistor, which is also 5 kilo ohm. So 5 kilo ohm resistor. Well, and that will give us 6.36, approximately 6.4 nanofarad. Okay. Now I'm going to my schematic. So I'm giving the 6.4 nanofarad. Here also 6.4 nanofarad. This one is 5K. This one is also 5K. Well, and R2 and R1, as we know from the condition of oscillation for Owen bridge oscillator, that should be 2 times of R1. So I'm choosing here 2K and here 1K, like that. And now I need to go for the simulation. So what type of simulation I need to choose? Obviously, I need to observe the cycles that will be produced by the circuit. So the cycles will be produced in the time domain. Okay, so that's why the transient response is the desired one. So transient response, the stop time. Well, so what should be the stop time? As I have already explained, that the stop time should be the time over which you want to observe the number of cycles. So here I am interested to observe, suppose 10 cycle. So what is the period of this of the frequency? So if the 5 kilohertz is the signal it should generate, then one period will be of 0.2 millisecond. Therefore the 10 period will be 2 milliseconds. So 2 millisecond will be for 10 periods. And start to saving data, I'm considering it is starting, it will start directly from 0 second, and maximum time step will be say 0.01 millisecond. Okay, well, now simulate. Okay, what is the problem? Where is the problem? Some value I have missed to give some value, I think. Values, oh, the supplies, I missed the supplies. So 10 volt for positive and minus 10 volt for negative. Okay, well, now yeah, look at that. No, nothing. So the output is not showing any type of oscillator, any kind of oscillation. So where is the problem? Problem is with the condition of oscillation. Okay, because this condition of oscillation I have chosen exactly as required as a theory, but practically the condition of oscillation should be maintained a bit higher than the theory stated. So therefore I need to put 2.1k instead of that. Well, 2.1k, but still nothing. But you should observe, you should see that the voltage level is changed. Let's see once again. If I put it back to 2k, just observe, it is 0.0 millivolt and it is this line is straight and following the 0 volt line. Okay, but when I'm putting this 2.1k, so as you can see, it's starting from some 26.9 nanovolt, and as you can see, some glitches you can observe, you may observe over here, and this line is not following the 0 volt line. So 26.9 nanovolt is almost 0 volt, so it is not following that line. It's somewhat deviating, so that means the oscillation is trying to start. Okay, but it is beyond of our observations. Why? Because I have started to observe directly from 0 millisecond. Okay, so this is basically zero to a few, starting from 0 millisecond to a couple of millisecond, it is generally considered as the transient response or the transient states are occurring. So this is the state, so this is not a steady state or the final states. Okay, so let's increase the time to start saving data. That means when you are going to start the observation, suppose after 30 millisecond, and stop time is obviously 32 millisecond, because within the 2 millisecond the 10 cycle will appear for the 5 kilohertz signal. Now simulate it again. Yeah, look at that, look at that. So these are the oscillation you can see. I didn't change anything. Only 2.1 I have changed. You may make it 2.05. If you will make it, let's see. Look at here. So this is somehow they are trying to oscillate. The oscillation is starting. Okay, so this is that I'm calling it the transient state. So when you you will start your observation from the 0 millisecond, you may not see that transient state, okay, because it takes longer time to appear these oscillations. Therefore, this transient state may not be observable if you set the starting observation time as 0 millisecond. So let's put it back. Okay, let it 0.8. What will happen? Yeah, look at that. A smooth transient signal we can observe. And now, as we see, that although I have chosen the period starting from 30 millisecond to 32 milliseconds, so here also I can see a clear transient responses, although the signal is not reaching steady state until this one, until 2 millisecond. So I mean, here it is 2 millisecond means 32 millisecond. Okay, so let choose it 42 millisecond and starting from 40 millisecond. Okay, because at 32 millisecond already the signal reaches its peak value or its maximum value, and here we can see the oscillation. Okay, so now you can play with the circuit and you can do yourself with different circuits, or you can change your values of the resistor and capacitors to produce different to produce a signal with different frequency. So do it yourself. In my next tutorial, we will see the phase shift oscillator. Till then, thank you very much.